Amerika, welcome to another episode of Let's Talk Taíno. I'm your host, Priscilla Colon, co-founder creative here at Casareito, where our mission is to promote the Taíno language and culture. So a few episodes ago, we learned the numbers 1 through 10. Today, we're going to use those to talk about the days of the week. But first, we're going to go over some historical information about how our Taíno ancestors' calendar system was. Our Taíno ancestors had a solar-lunar calendar. Their month was made up of a 28-day lunar or moon cycle. As you know, this is related to our own female biological cycle. The Taínos also kept track of the years, which were made up of 13 moons or months. In order to keep track of the months and the years, the Taínos were astronomers. They studied the position of the stars in the sky, including stars we know today as Venus, the Pleiades, Orion, and Sirius. Of course, they had different names for those stars. If you're interested in learning more about the astronomical calendar system that our ancestors had, I highly recommend reading Taínos and Caribes, Taínos y Caribes by Sebastián Robio Lamarche. This book is available in both English and Spanish and has many eye-opening discoveries. So why did the Taínos have a solar-lunar calendar? What did it help them with? Well, it helped them with a lot. First of all, they were sailors. They navigated the entire Caribbean, sailing up to what is now the southern part of the United States, parts of Mexico, Central America, and South America as well. So studying the stars is really important to know where you are located at any point in the ocean. So they used this calendar for navigation. Another thing that they tracked with this calendar were things like the rainy season, the planting season, the hurricane season. You wouldn't want to be caught in the middle of the ocean in the middle of a hurricane, right? And the dry season. So it was really important to keep track of all of these things so that you knew when it was time to do what. Nowadays, most of us use the Gregorian calendar that not only tracks months and years, but also tracks weeks and the days of the week. So that is what we're going to be learning today. We've had to adapt some of the words to be able to communicate using a modern day calendar system. So there are a few words that you will need to know before we get started. That includes kai, which is day. Now you have seen the word kai in the word sokai, which means today. You will also need to know akarakai, which is week or the days of the week. The days of the week follow a simple formula. First, you have kai, which means day. Then you add the number. Each day of the week will have one number starting with 1, then going to 7. This number is the short form that we learned. So let's do the first example together, Monday. So Monday in this modern Taíno calendar is considered day 1. So we're literally going to create Monday by saying day, kai, and hek, 1. You see the formula? So we're going to do Tuesday, day 2, Wednesday, day 3, Thursday, day 4, and so on. So let's take a look at the days of the week, Monday through Sunday. Kai, hek, Monday. Kai, ka, Tuesday. Kai-kun, Wednesday. Kai-kobiks, Thursday. Kai-kobre, Friday. Kai-pirua, Saturday. Kai-akarat, Sunday. Now that you know the days of the week, we're going to do a little exercise where I'm going to ask you to look at the calendar and tell me what day of the week the special holiday falls on. Are you ready? When is Memorial Day? Kai hek, Monday. When is the first day of Black History Month? Kai ka, Tuesday. When is the first day of LGBTQ Pride Month? Kai-kun, Wednesday. When is Cinco de Mayo? Kai-kobiks, Thursday. When is Veterans Day? Kai-kobre, Friday. When is New Year's Day? Kai-pirua, Saturday. When is Mother's Day? Kai-akarat, Sunday. Wasn't that easy to do? So just by putting kai with a number, you can create the days of the week, Monday through Sunday. Now, I'll give you a couple of tips to get you started to practice the days of the week. One of the things you can do is you can write them down each day if you keep a journal or a diary. Another thing you can do is you can write them in Taíno on a calendar. So if you still have a paper calendar that you hang up like I do sometimes, just write the days of the week in Taíno on top. That will help you practice the days of the week. So let's review one more time all of the words that we learned during today's lesson. Kai, day. Sokai, today. Akarakai, week or days of the week. Kai hek, Monday. Kai ka, Tuesday. Kai kun, Wednesday. Kai kobiks, Thursday. Kai kobre, Friday. Kai pirua, Saturday. Kai akarat, Sunday. I hope that you enjoyed today's lesson. I hope that you learned a little bit more about the history of our Taíno ancestors' calendar system, and you learned how to talk about the modern days of the week, Monday through Sunday. Now you can do a lot in Taíno. You can talk about what you are going to be doing on Monday, maybe what you did last Tuesday, etc. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button so you can stay in the know of our latest community posts and other live events. Also, check out our kids' book. They are a great way to teach kids Taíno. I want to say a special thank you, hahom, to all of you who are tuning in from Sweden and Canada, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, Germany, all over the world. There's so many of us learning Taíno, and you are making my dream come true, because as I always say, I know together we can bring back Taíno. Until next time, Tai Karaya Guaitiao Nagu.